Hey guys, it's Jeff Gilden. I'm about to show you how to create a website with Bluehost Website Builder. It's very simple, very easy. Anyone can make a website and create a website. Very simple, basic version, or you know, if you're good at design and that sort of thing, you can go a little bit overboard. So anyway, let's dive right in. I've got a link in the description below. It'll hyperlink you over to Bluehost and give you the best price over there. I'm going to share my screen right now. Looks like it's I think it's $4.95 right now, you know, per month. All you do is click get started, and I'm about to show you the website builder in a second, but this is how you sign up and get started. I'll just do example. If you have a domain name, you put it in there. If you don't have a domain name, you can actually get Bluehost to register it. So if you want to registermyname.com, and it'll add that fee to it. It's probably $12 a year or something like that. Anyway, just type in your domain name if you have one, or register one here. Click next. Take you to the next page. Fill out your information. Choose a package. And then you don't need site backup or site lock or anything extra. You just need the basic hosting package. You can do a 12-month or 36-month, 24-month, however you want to do that. Enter your information, hit next, and then you'll just follow everything else to finalize this purchase. Once you actually have a package and you log into Bluehost, you'll see this area right here. This is your dashboard. And you'll have a few options. Now, the easiest way to create a website, we'll just go here to install WordPress. You click on that, it'll hyperlink you over to the Mojo Marketplace, where you'll be able to one-click practically install WordPress on your website. Literally just click install. That'll load it up. You choose which domain you want to install WordPress on. You'll have the domains in your account here. Click check domain. It'll check to see if you're able to actually install on that install, and it'll say that it's not set up or it is set up and everything's okay. In this case, we haven't pointed the domain name servers here, so anyway, show advanced options. You can actually give your site a title if you want, and username Jeff Gilden, and whatever. Yada, 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 yada. Automatically create a new database. I've read. Click install, and this will install a basic WordPress install on your domain and get everything set up. Once you are set up with the website, it will look something like this. So jeffgilden.com, it'll just say just another WordPress site. Hello world. This is just a basic how WordPress comes out of the box. There's a lot of customizations that you can do in the back end. You'll go to wp-admin. That'll take you to the admin area. And then what you're going to do is simply use your username and your login. Click login. That'll take you to the dashboard of your WordPress install. Now, if there's any kind of updates or anything like that, just click on please update now, and it'll give you the latest and greatest. Click update now, the latest and greatest of WordPress. This version that they have come out with actually changes the look a little bit. It's got a lot of different features and is really, really good. So you can hover over the dashboard and go back to updates, and let's just install the next. And there's also an update up here, shows you how many updates there are. We can click select all and update all of these plugins if we want to at one time, and that'll take care of that. It's really important to update all this when you start out. It'll take care of any bugs that are in the system, and make sure that everything's running smooth. Now in this case, I'm actually going to deactivate some of these plugins. If you're new to WordPress or new to creating a website, plugins are simply little programs, if you will, that just plug right into your website and give it some extra functionality. So, for example, redirection would allow us to redirect a page. Like, if there was a broken page on your website, you could redirect it to the homepage or something like that. You can do, there's a lot of spam plugins you can install if you want to put a calendar on here, if you want to put anything, any kind of functionality that you want to see on your website, you can just click add new and really just search. So if we wanted a calendar, for example, we could just click search, and then here's a bunch of calendars that we could literally just install on our website. So calendar event WordPress, editorial calendar, my calendar. So this provides richly customizable ways to display events. Sounds good. Click install, click OK, and you've just added a little bit of functionality to your website. And you'll have to click activate plugin, and this will probably show up here on the left-hand side. So you've got my calendar here, and you've got all new functionality on your site, and there's ways to integrate this as well. The other thing you want to look at is your themes. WordPress out of the box comes with 2012, 2014, 2013. There's a few themes installed. And literally, if we go to the home page, you'll see that it's the basic version. But if I come over to 2014 and click activate and go back to the home page, and let's refresh this, it has a whole new look. So WordPress has a repository that you can search. You literally can click add new theme and then search through the different themes that WordPress has available. So you can click on, let's do a preview of this one. So this one looks pretty good. Looks good. So let's just install this one, see what it looks like. And it'll just take a few seconds installing that on our site, because it's actually downloading that theme remotely. And we'll just click activate. And then once that's done, you'll see in your theme settings that everything has been completed here. You've got the new theme and it's active. And if we go back to the home page and hit refresh, you'll see that we have a new look. And you'll see all the text and buttons and headers and footers and all that good kind of stuff has all been done for us. And it's good to go. So the first thing you want to do, obviously, update all your plugins, update all the themes that are there. You want to choose a new theme from the repository, a new look. And then you want to add some plugins if you want different functionality. Some other things you want to do, come in here. I like to go into the settings and go to general, make sure site title, tagline, all this kind of stuff is set up. Email address is going to be the main email address on the website. You can set your time zone, time format, things like that. And then I like to get into some of these other options here. Writing, reading, discussion. Discussion, let's just walk through them. Writing, I don't really do anything in this area. Everything's set pretty good. Reading, this will, if your theme supports or asks you what your front page wants to be, or what you want your front page to be, simply click use a static page and choose the front page that you want to be displayed on your home page. Same as a blog, the post page, you can choose what page you want to be displayed, the post to be displayed on. Now if you're building the site and you don't want the search engines to find you yet, you can actually click this box. It'll discourage the search engines from indexing the website. Obviously, it's up to the search engines to honor that request, but for the most part, it usually works. Discussion is all about the comments and the chatter that goes on your website. Anyone can post a comment. Comments help for moderation. Some of these settings, you can find different ways to use these settings. Allow people to post comments on new articles. You can uncheck that, and it will disable comments on anything that you create that's new. And then anyone post a comment, these are email settings here, just some different things. And then you can choose default avatars and maximum rating for comments, that sort of thing. The other thing, when you're setting it up, you want to go to permalinks, make sure post name is chosen. Bluehost by default chooses post name, and then you should be good to go. The other two things you want to know about are your posts. These are blog, in a sense, blog posts that will feed out into your blog. For example, the blog posts are feeding in right here. So this is a blog post, a little excerpt, and then when you click on the title, it'll take you to a blog page. Here's an example of a comment. We can leave a comment. We can see recent posts, recent comments, archives, categories. This is the sidebar that you'll be dealing with as well. Let me show you where that is. Here's the blog, how the blog flows into the site. And the sidebar is over here. We're going to go into our dashboard to appearance, go to widgets. And these are all the widgets that you see in this sidebar. Now, a widget is literally just a little section, if you will. So let's say we want to take out meta. We just hit delete and come back to this page, refresh, and you'll see that meta goes away. So it's literally just these little sections that you can install. If you wanted, here's the calendar plugin that we installed. If you wanted to add, let's say we just wanted to add a text, testing text, and here is a text box widget. Hit save, and then if we go back to this page and refresh, there is my widget. There's a little sections you can add to the sidebar of your website. Now, the theme determines where the sidebar is, and different themes have different sidebar locations and styles and all that kind of stuff. But for the most part, you'll be able to control the sidebar from the widgets area. And there's tons of widgets that you can find online that will plug in little functionality over here, like calendars and pictures and slideshows and that sort of thing. The other thing that you'll need to know is how to create a page. So if we want to add a page here, just click Add New, My Awesome Page. And there is that. And so now we are listening to